Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operations Research. And this is lecture number 6.2 in the inventory model. We are discussing the solution for inventory model. In this lecture, we are going to discuss the deterministic inventory model number 2, the solution procedure and the solving problem in this lecture. The learning outcome to the students: at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in the deterministic inventory model. So, model number 2, the various assumptions for the model: no shortage is permitted, demand rate is uniform, and production rate is finite. In the earlier model, we discussed the production rate infinite. Now, here production rate is finite. And the time t, so this is the diagrammatic representation of this model, and here the total time interval t is divided into two times, t1 and t2. During the time t1, the stock level increases at the rate of k minus r, and at the point A, top of the triangle, the stock level is im. Then the stock level decreases at a uniform rate r. Once the time point B is reached, once again the stock level is increasing at the rate of k minus r. So, where k is the production rate, r is the demand rate. So, the time t consists of two parts, t1. So, first time t1 is the time during which the stock is building up at the rate of k minus r, and t2 is the time during which no production and the stock level consumed at a rate of r. Now, where the im from the triangle, im equal to the instantaneous stock level equal to k minus r by k into q, and the time t equal to q by r. Q is the stock level and r is the demand rate. Im is the stock level at the end of the time t1 and is consumed during the time t2 at a rate of r. Now, holding cost at for time t, holding cost equal to 1 by 2 im into t into c1. So, 1 by 2 im into t is the area of the triangle into c1 is the holding cost per unit time. And the setup cost is c3. The total cost per production run equal to holding cost plus setup cost. So, this c equal to 1 by 2 c1 im into t plus c3. The average cost per unit time, so dividing by the previous equation by the time, so C im comma t equal to C by t, so the previous equation divided by the time, which is 1 by 2 C1 into im plus C3 by t. Now, substituting the value of im from the previous definition, so C equal to 1 by 2 C1 into k minus r by k into q plus C3 by q into r. Now, the cost will be optimum if dc by dq equal to 0 and d square c by tq square equal to is greater than 0 or positive. Now, differentiate in this equation. The original equation c equal to 1 by 2 c1 k minus r by k into q plus c3 by q into r. So, differentiating with respect to q, dc by dq equal to 1 by 2 c1 k minus r by k minus c3 r divided by q square. And differentiating again, d square c by dq square equal to 2c3r by q to the power 3. So, this is positive. Now, to get the optimum cost, to calculate the optimum stock level, and the second equation is to be equal to 0, dc by tq equal to 0. So, from here, 1 by 2 c1 k minus r by k minus c3 r by q square equal to 0. Rearrange the terms, 1 by 2 C1 into k minus r by k equal to C3 r by q square. So, the optimum stock level QO equal to k by k minus r into 2 C3 r by C1. So, the optimum stock level. So, if you compare with the previous model QO equal to 2 C3 r by C1. Now, it is multiplied by k minus r. Then, optimum time interval TO equal to QO by r. So, substituting for QO, this becomes square root of k by k minus r into 2 C3 by C1 r, and optimum cost. So, the cost equation, in the cost equation, we substitute the QO value. So, 1 by 2 C1 k minus r by k into QO plus C3 R divided by QO. So, substituting for QO, C equal to 1 by 2 C1 K minus R by K into square root of K by K minus R plus into 2 C3 R by C1 plus C3 R by QO, substituting for QO, square root of K by K minus R into 2 C3 R by C1. So, simplifying, so this will be equal to K minus square root of K minus R by K plus C1 C3 R by 2 plus square root of K minus R by K into C1 C3 R by 2. So, this is 2 times of square root of K minus R by K into C1 C3 R by 2. So, simplifying further, so taking 2 into the square bracket, the cost total optimum cost equal to square root of K minus R by K into 2 times of C1 C3 and R, where K is the production rate, R is the demand rate, C1 is the holding cost, and C3 is the setup cost. So, the equation that you have to remember, so the optimum stock level, so QO equation you have to remember, TO equation you have to remember, and the CO equations that you have to remember. Now, we take one numerical example to understand the model. Example number 4, the demand for certain raw material is 40 units per month at a rate of rupees 1200 per unit. It costs rupees 182 to place an order each time, and the holding cost is rupees 2 per unit per month. The supply rate is 10 units per day, and there is no lead time. What is the optimum order quantity? How many orders are placed in a year? So, the demand rate is 40 units per month. Setup cost equal to C3 equal to rupees 180. Holding cost equal to 2 per unit per month. And the production rate is 10 units per day, which is 300 units per month. Now, the optimum order quantity, so QO equal to square root of K by K minus R into 2 C3 R by C1, which is square root of 300 by 300 minus 40 into 2 into 180 into 40 divided by 2 is equal to 91 units. So, the optimum order quantity is 91 units, and optimum time interval TO equal to QO by R. So, 91 by 40 equal to 2.275 months. And number of orders per year, this n equal to 1 by TO into 12. So, this equal to 1 by 2.275 into 12 equal to 5.27 orders per year. That is the answer to the problem. Example number 5. Find the optimal production lot size and the optimal cycle length when the production rate is 8000 units per year, annual demand is 2000 units, setup cost is rupees 300 per run, and the holding cost is rupees 1.6 per unit per year. So, here demand rate is R equal to 2000 units per year, setup cost C3 equal to rupees 300, holding cost C1 equal to rupees 1.6 per unit per month per year, and production rate is 8000 units per year. Now, you have to calculate optimum order quantity. So, optimum order quantity QO, the equation is square root of K by K minus R into 2 C3 R by C1. Substituting numerical value, square root of 8000 divided by 8000 minus 2000 into 2 into 300 into 2000 divided by 1.6 equal to 1000 units. And the optimum time interval or cycle length equal to TO equal to QO by R equal to 1000 divided by 2000 equal to 0.5 years. We take another example, example number 6, find the optimal production rate, optimum time interval between the orders, optimum cost, number of orders per year for the following details of a manufacturing company. The annual demand of certain item is 150, the production rate is 600 per year, the setup cost is rupees 50 and the holding cost is rupees 1.2 per unit per year. So, we are given demand rate equal to 150 units per year, setup cost equal to C3 equal to 50. Holding cost C1 equal to 1.2 per unit per year, and the production rate is K equal to 600 units per year. First, the optimum order quantity QO equal to square root of K by K minus R into 2 C3 R by C1. So, the substituting numerical value is QO equal to square root of 600 divided by 600 minus 150 into 2 into 50 into 150 divided by 1.2 equal to 129 units. And the optimum time interval or the cycle length equal TO equal to QO by R equal to 129 by 150 equal to 0.86 years. Number of orders per year, N equal to 1 by TO equal to 1 by 0.86 equal to 1.16 years orders per year. and optimum inventory cost C equal to square root of K minus R by K into 2 C1 C3 R. Substituting numerical values, square root of 600 minus 150 divided by 600 into 2 into 1.2 into 50 into 150 equal to rupees 161.2. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. You can refer to the book Operation Research for additional information on the Operation Research subject. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me for any information or help in the subject through my WhatsApp number or the email ID. I will meet again with another video lecture on the inventory model. Until then, bye bye.